Good morning from Melbourne. This is your coach. Shannon, I've watched your videos. I'm gonna make you one video for pull-ups today, and then I'll send you another video this week on the handstand push-ups. The pull-ups do have an extra kick, and the way we fix that is we've got to strengthen your kip. You have enough pulling power and strength in the arms. You can do lots of strict pull-ups, but the problem is we need to be able to generate more force with our kip so our chest just floats up there. One of the things that we're going to have to change is that you're bending at the hip. And I want all the bending to happen in your shoulders, and you keep your core and your hips engaged. I want you to think about lying on the air, floating on the air, almost lying down. I'm gonna give you some demonstrations. But the thing I want you to remember is, as soon as you start bending at the hip and piking at the hip, you're gonna lose the energy that you need for that great kip.
Play?
Yep.
Okay, Shannon, this is the video showing you how to really stay engaged here and not piking at the hip, and think about lying. Your body's going to be straight and lying on the ground, on the air. So I'm going to start my hip, pointed toes, forward, back, straight legs, straight legs, straight legs. That's the way I want it to look. This is the wrong way, and this is the way where we lose a lot of energy and power just leaks out. If I start kipping like this. Okay, so the big difference there is not to hinge at the hips, but to hinge at the shoulders and keep your butt and your glutes and everything tight, and get your shoulders higher and higher, building until you're lying almost on an air mattress. This is your coach. Take care.